going. Okay, I'll try again. Right, today I'm going to show you, firstly, happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there. Today I'm going to show you how to make a South African poikie. Oxtail poikie. The tail of an ox. Right, so we've got this pot here. Nice big cast iron pot that I bought. It's got three legs. Reason for that is it will sit over a fire. But we'll get to the fire in a bit. So, start this off. I mean, it's quite a long process. It takes about between 4 and 5 hours, the whole thing. So, first we need some wood. And we'll start with that. You gotta make a fire, so you gotta find some wood. Because of the old virus going around, it's hard to get outside. So what we're gonna do is, it's hard to find some wood. So if you do have a spare rocking bench in the back of your garden, it's always a good place to start. Okay, so I've been preparing some ingredients that we'll need for this poikie. By the way, that's Kenny Rogers in the background. I will drink a drink on old Kenny later. It's one of my favorites. Okay, so what we've got is bacon, chopped up. We've got carrots and potatoes. I leave in a bit of water because it stays fresh longer. Chopped up onion, some red pepper. We've got some butterscotch here, some leek, a bit of corn. Here we've got some garlic. I normally use fresh garlic. I ain't got any, so I'm not going to venture out there for that. So I'm going to use that. I'm going to use this. Some spice, salt, pepper. This is some South African spice we got. It's quite cool because it changed from Bright Salt to Bright Salt. Afrikaans in the flip. And here we've got the oxtail. Now what we've done with the oxtail is you sort of roll it in flour, cloud it with that first, and then loads of spice. So we're just gonna wait for that to settle. Here we've got some stock, some tomato puree, some butter, red wine, which I'll show you later. That's probably the best bit. Okay, so these are the ingredients you need. Let's get up. Right, so after trying to knock down the swinging bench, I realized I had some charcoal, hardwood charcoal, always the best. So what we've got here is a little fire area. So what you want is you want it sort of enclosed so you don't spill it onto your decking or your floor, and also to protect young kids from running around and putting their hands up there. So that'll be the fire. What we're going to do next is stick the pot on top. So what you want to do is get the pot set on nice on top like that. Perfect. We'll wait for that to heat up and then we'll start. Right, so here we go. So what I've done is I've put all the onion and leek in the pot with a bit of garlic and some butter, and we're just gonna let it simmer nice and easy, stir every now and again just to make sure it doesn't burn onto the bottom of the pot. Perfect. We'll give that a bit of time. So now that the have a look. So now that the onions are and leeks have sort of softened up a bit, what we want to do is add the bacon. Now what we want to do with the bacon is we want to brown it. So just going to stir it in. Ooh, that smells amazing. Just going to stir in with the onion and leek and garlic. I'm going to give that a little bit more time to brown. Stirring it, keep an eye on it. But while that's going off in there, just give it another stir. What you want to do is just add a bit of black pepper there. That's it. A little bit of, I've got rock salt here. Fantastic. don't forget to stay hydrated, because a poiki takes bloody long. And you know, you don't want to pass out with all the heat coming from the fire, so gotta be very careful. There you go, stay hydrated always. Okay, so what we've done here is we've made a makeshift 10 peg, because you will find that your lid will get warmer as the time goes on. So my lovely wife here, okay, what we're gonna do now is scoop out all of that onion and bacon and leek into a container. You want it all out of the pot. There you go. Fantastic. Wow, smells amazing. Okay. That's quite a lot of it. Doing a good job there, darling.
Thank you. I have my uses.
Yeah, it's just that I would have done it, but I'm just hydrating at the moment.
Okay.
Right, fantastic. Now that's all scooped out. Great
okay.
job.
So now in goes our oxtail. All we want to do is we want to stick it in, and we want to brown it. Nice. So we're going to leave it in there till it's nice and brown, and then we're going to take it out again. Lovely. Okay, let's give that a bit of time. Right, make sure you do move around your oxtail, keep it all nice and brown. Gonna last you over. That smells amazing. Right, really good. Right, let's have a look. They look nice and brown now, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna take them out. What you can do is you can just add them with the mix you took out earlier, the onion. There you go, nice and brown, lovely.
Yes.
Great. What we're going to do now is we're just going to add a bit of red wine to the pot. What we're doing is actually we're going to just glaze the bottom. All you want to do is just lay the bottom. It's sort of preparing the pot for what comes next. Nice. So I would say half a glass of wine. That should do the trick. And what we'll do is we'll just create another layer of smoothness at the bottom. Lovely. So now that pot is nicely glazed with the wine, what we're going to do is go back to the mixture and we're going to add it all inside the pot. So we let that simmer for a little bit. We're going to add our stock. Get it all in there. Nice stir.
you want to do then is we're just going to add some more wine to it. So we want to get about half a bottle in there. Fantastic. Okay, so after giving it about half an hour or so, just to simmer. What we're going to do now is add the carrots and potatoes. Good. Can I have my wooden spoon? In there, we're just going to submerge it. Really good. So, what we'll do is we'll give this about an hour or so, just to simmer. Just stir that in. What does it smell like, darling?
Amazing.
Oh, good.
Amazing.
Okay, very good. And, okay, we'll give an hour or so. One thing you need to keep checking is that your fire is sort of going at all times, so the best thing to do is just have a bag of charcoal ready, and every now and again just stick a few under the pot. Well, so for the best. Okay, so waiting for the poiki to simmer, we will revert to some family activities. I'll be bowling to my son, the ginger one, right arm over, and hopefully taking his off stump out the ground. Hey, get off the wicket! You're on the wicket! Right, here it comes. Oh! Right, so what we're going to add now is we're going to add the corn. Yeah, very good. And the peppers. What we're also going to add is the sweet potato and butterscotch.
Yeah. Ready?
And we're just going to let that sit on top for a little while before we stir it in. Right, make sure not to fall asleep on the job, not a good idea. I'm just going to get these potatoes, or sweet potato and butterscotch. We're just going to try and submerge them. There we go. Right, so we're just going to be adding some tomato puree to it. Right, so let's have a look. They say, oh my God, I see the way you shine. Take your hand, my dear, and bless them both in mine. Who knows who stopped me that I was passing by? So what we're gonna add now is just a bit of a broccoli. I'm just gonna leave it on the top. Back to the point. One last stir, and I think we're there. I'm not trying to be your part-time lover. Sign me up for them full-time. I'm yours. All yours. So what a man gotta do? What a man gotta do? To be totally locked up by you. Fantastic. What a man gotta say. Right, so finally here, all done. I suppose the best way to serve it is with some rice. Right. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. And there you have it, South African poiki. Also, don't forget to have some red wine with it. Well, I hope you enjoy that. I've learned one thing, and that is never to make any food videos. Oh.